Hey guys, welcome back. I'm playing on Carillon Hamlet by Chael Sonnen. So, something I've not done in a while is I've actually turned all the Zeds off. They're all frozen in place, and I want to do another map review where I basically just spend one wave running around and exploring everything and reviewing everything. This is going to be another non-combat review. I'm not going to fight over and over and eventually get to the boss. I'm just going to do map review, so no combat. And I want to see what you guys think. Let me know in the comments below. So, let's get to it, shall we? I'm liking all these extra custom textures and possibly custom models here as well, so let's get to it, shall we? Let's do all the indoor sections first. So I'm liking the choice of texture here. This is actually a style of pavement that we actually have near my house, which is quite interesting. As for the road, instead of just like a standard, like bland road texture, this is clearly old, which sort of matches the age of the buildings around nearby. It's clearly used up, it's crumbled. And this building itself looks pretty old and used up as well. Okay, right, I've got a bit of a texture flicker there, so just bear that in mind. Now, something I need to cover straight away is the fact that this map is frozen, which means I can't fire my weapon, so I don't know if there's any lighting that can be destroyed here. That's just one thing to bear in mind. Now, look at the level of detail just on this wall right here. So, clearly this is some sort of door here, and this isn't a flat texture. This is actually sticking out right here that goes all the way down there, along with this handle here. It might not seem like much, but also bear in mind, look at this. You've got the texture of the wall itself, you've got these metal bars that run across, and you've even got some sort of extra wall plating here. All of this, just in one little section. Because there hasn't been a map that, in my opinion, is a good map in a long time. Like, it's been 3 weeks since my last map review. And just look at this. This is what I consider a really good map. There are a lot of maps out there that come out regularly, but I don't think they're good enough to review. So, it's been a while. And, of course, you can kind of see what this room is used for. You've got, like, a little radio transmitter here with all sorts of different settings on it. And, of course, just looking above here, this is a very old building. Like, above the air conditioning here, you've got these sort of different plates that have clearly been falling off somewhere. However, the first negative thing I have to say about this, where did they fall to? They're not actually on the floor here, and it doesn't look like there's been any sort of cleaning around here. Well, I guess this is kind of like a relatively clear floor, but this plating's gone somewhere, and I'm kind of curious as to where it's gone. Because it's not been put in a corner or anything. So I have to say, what is interesting about this, and I've mentioned it in map reviews before, these like chairs and tables, they were clearly like in the middle of the room at some point, and they have been moved, like in an out of the way kind of position, along with these lockers here. And it just made me think, where did these go? Now, they've probably been put somewhere. Now, just moving on to the next room, a huge amount of detail here once again. So, just looking at the floor here, this does seem to be flat along here, but you've got different textures for the rails of whatever this thing is. But of course, you've also got all these electric cables and piping here to sort of fuel whatever kind of machine this is. I don't know what it is, and this is a standard model here, so I think these are too. So, I'm guessing it's not supposed to be quite clear exactly what these are, but a lot of thought has been gone into this, like, how is this thing powered? You've even got, like, the entire electrical system on display here, which is quite interesting. It does make you think, like, at some point has someone come in here and actually decided to try and rework what this is used for. I mean, it might sound like I'm going on a bit, and I'll be honest, I am kind of going on a bit, but when you're actually designing a map, making a map area look like it's supposed to does take a bit of thought. Like, instead of just dumping a room, going, here's a machine in the middle, there you go, this room's done. No, there's a lot of thought that's been put into this. Like, this is clearly some sort of engineering room where things are being built, which means there's certain extra details that have to follow along with that. And of course, we've even got a section of the floor we can see in here, with some piping below. I mean, this could just be a flat texture, kind of like if you go into this other room. Yeah, this is a flat floor, I mean, that makes sense. This is where all the machinery is, so just adding on a little bit of texture here, a little bit of extra detail. I mean, this is basically copy and pasted here and over here, but there's nothing wrong with that. That's extra floor detail. It just adds to the vibrant display of the room. And of course you've got some sort of air conditioning up here. I'm guessing, well, this is above the machinery. I guess you think that whatever this does, maybe it produces some smoke or fumes or something. And that's just an extra reason as to why this is up here. When it's like, what detail do I add to my roof? Because, I mean, there are so many maps I play and come across where I think, I'm not going to bother reviewing this because it's just bland. This is like, if you're wondering, like, if you're making a map yourself, you think, well, what sort of detail could I, like, put on my roof? I don't know, it's just a ceiling, right? What sort of stuff do you have other than lights? Well, here's an example. I mean, obviously this is some sort of workshop, but if you're going to put anything that sort of sucks up the air and smoke and things, well, you put it above your machinery, don't you, where it's produced, and then that goes off somewhere. Doesn't matter where it goes, but that's just something to do. And of course, this isn't a flat roof. You've got loads of metal barring again, and of course you've got more air conditioning up here. Very interesting. Like, if you look at the detail of some things, you can just get so much information about it, and also so many ideas to your own maps. And of course, we've got some railing here for the section below, which we'll check out in just a moment. And I'm liking the shadows as well. We've got the lighting source, the sun's over there somewhere behind the clouds. And of course, here the lighting comes in, produces the shadows along here. Also, lighting and shadows can be a good area to just... can be a good way of adding some texture itself. Like, for example, if this is like electrical stuff here and got a box, but if that wasn't there, there is still detail on this section from the lighting and the shadows, and the lighting is from here, because of these pipes here, is also being producing even more detail on here. This can help make a very bland floor become a lot more detailed, and of course you've got some crossover here as well, which is nice, as in this actually is working here, it's not just kind of, is it one or the other, it's actually fixed there. Okay, so this is the corner that goes round to where I was before, but let's just check out this indoor area some more. So we've got some more piping here, again, this could be a very bland floor, but not only have we got the lighting and shadows here, but we've got some extra details similar to the ones up there. And of course, with it being a workshop that produces things, how do they move the boxes around? Well, this is an extra idea for what sort of detail you can add in. There's a box on one of these carts here, and there's an empty one. And this is like one of those doors that slides up and down. So you might think, well, what do I do for my wall detail? Well, how do you think they move the door up and down? That's what this thing likely is. Oh, and there's some interesting detail as well. This isn't just a standard set of stairs, look. If you can see, they aren't straight lines across, they're actually clearly being used a lot, and they're actually, you know, they've taken in some pressure here. People walking down up a lot, and it's slowly wearing the stairs away. It's not necessary, but it's an extra level of detail that's clearly been thought about and has been added in. In fact, you've even got some chips in the side of the wall here, probably from things like knocking into it. This is clearly a very old warehouse that's just seen a lot of use. And it's a warehouse. What do you need in a warehouse and other places? Fire extinguisher. If you're ever wondering what sort of things you can add as extra detail to your maps, these are the sorts of things you need to think about. What is the room used for? What does it do? What things should be there? Now, of course, when it comes to clutter, I'm not seeing much yet as the moment I mention it. Here's some extra stuff here, and of course, you've got the cracked texture there. We've also got little pieces of concrete, I'm guessing, from somewhere, perhaps maybe above, or it's just been swept to the side here, and of course we've got some wooden planks. Now this is clearly just as a way to get past here and drop down, but it's an extra way of thinking, like, if the railing wasn't there, what was put there? And clearly there's a bit of railing that may have broken off. I don't see it down there anywhere just yet, but we'll have a check. I don't know what this is, but something interesting to put there. I mean, you don't have to understand what everything is. I mean, I don't work in a warehouse. Maybe it's very obvious what this is supposed to be, but just a few extra things. And I like the fact that it's not just boxes, 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 boxes. Like, I need some detail for a box warehouse. Boxes. Obviously, yeah, there are plenty of boxes here, but that's not the only thing that's here. And also, all the boxes aren't closed. It's given me some sort of idea as to what sort of things are being put in the boxes. So as an extra level of detail, instead of just leaving a box, you've got some open ones that sort of show what sort of things they might be putting in there. And of course we've got some more lighting down here, and I like how there aren't any just flat walls. Like, you might say, you mean like this? Well, no. Not only is there loads of detail on here, but you've also got these sort of indents here. You've got step-up indents, different sort of pillaring here. A lot of detail is going to the side of these walls. Now, number three, perhaps off in the distance, we haven't had a check yet, perhaps in the distance there'll be other warehouses? or the sections of the warehouse that give you a reason for that being number 3. I know that I'm going into a bit high level of detail here, but it does seem like, well, this is an old warehouse, it is being worked on, because this looks quite new, at least in comparison to other things. And of course you've got Horzine Radio. It's not playing anything right now, however, I need to point out, because the map is frozen, that might be playing audio, but we can't hear it. It depends exactly how the extra audio has been set up. And next to all of these construction things, a trader. It's a good place to put it. And as a section that you can't go to, I love how out of bounds detail is really high on certain maps. Like, I don't know where that goes. That's some sort of underground system that goes somewhere that's clearly... I don't know what these things are. I guess they're pipes? They kind of look like rails, but then because they kind of cross over here, that kind of cancels that out. But they go somewhere. Not sure where, but... I don't know where the Zed spawn on here. Maybe they actually spawn right down at the end, so you can kind of snipe them off from standing here, but that's just something to think about. And of course, if I stand at the right angle here, you can kind of see the sort of shiny borders here. So it's clearly wet in there, whatever that is. And of course, you've got more air conditioning, lots of crates and stuff, lots of pipes, and a very detailed roof once again. So let's have a bit more of a look around. I'm guessing that whatever this stuff is on the floor is from digging out somewhere, maybe digging out the tunnel there, or perhaps a bit further on over here. Now, that missing railing isn't actually missing, it's actually just bent over, and I'm glad that that's still there. Of course, I've got to be careful of my torch battery here, but now, there's not too much extra clutter around here, but this stuff is being dug out from whatever these mines are, so I'm actually kind of interested that there is an underground segment that I didn't know about, so let's check this out. Of course, we've got some rails here. This is where my lovely Zed spawned. Oh, and I like this. Okay. Lots of extra ways to move around your map. There's a hole here. It's a one-way trip, but there you go. There's all sorts of different loops around that lead to the same similar areas. So, as we experience this underground section, I need to bear in mind there are some underground sections to check out. So, I guess Horzine's found something under here, hasn't they? So, of course, these walls aren't completely flat. You've got some interesting texture here to cover up the parts that are. Other than that, you've got like a curved roof, you've got different chunks coming out, and of course you've got over the top of that to kind of cover up the fact that some of these sides are fairly flat. Of course, that's kind of how it works when you're modelling them, but you've got the wooden framework and of course different cables and stuff all over the place. Help give that extra bit of texture. And of course, they definitely have found something, because that's not supposed to be in a mine, is it? Now, I'm actually going to go to the left first, so I'm kind of curious. This does loop a bit round to where we were before. Well, there's the, like, that piping that came out. Could I actually... Is it the same piping? It might be. I'm not too sure on my positioning here. I think it's maybe a bit lower down. And, of course, we've got this side segment. It's good, instead of just having walls, 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 like, well, what extra things can I add? Well, there's kind of like a little cordoned off site here where there's a digger. Clearly they're making a bit more progress into this pipe here. And we've got some extra lighting in here from sort of things that the construction workers have added. I'm kind of curious to see if that's actually the same thing as it was around there, like that pipe I'm looking into. Or perhaps that's a bit higher up, I'm not sure. But speaking of higher up, clearly they've actually like broken into this tunnel here, and you can see what the interior of this concrete was. It's got this sort of metal framework as well. That's interesting. And of course we've got like a little upper segment with wooden blocks and floorboarding, that's the word I was looking for. Thanks, brain, just when I needed you. And of course, as far as clutter goes, we've got extra broken pieces of rock from the roof and stuff. So let's check this area out. Of course, we're leading into another building right now, I need to bear this in mind. But thankfully I've got some Zeds to remind me exactly what I'll be looking at when I'm up there checking this out. Can I actually go up here? No, I can't. But for the sake of fall damage, we've got some crates here that you can drop down to, and hopefully you don't take any damage when you drop down there. But ah, okay. This is what we need, the escape route. However, I'll check out where that goes. Some interesting stuff there. Ah, there's that cleaning stuff? I don't know. We'll check out where this goes. And I hope it goes to the same warehouse, so we'll check it out. Of course, we've got the similar thoughts about floor detail as we were in the previous room. However, this has got grating on rather than metal barring. And of course, lots of wall detail. We've got cables and pipes behind this sort of metal framework that was in the other room as well. Basically, instead of just going over something new, this building was built the same way, so some things will be, well, some sort of building ideas will be repeated. And there's some dodge, but guess what? Because it's frozen, I can't use my gun, I can't pick it up. So, this map has collectibles. And something you can notice here is we've got like a flickering light, and it would have sparks coming off it. However, again, because the map is frozen, they're also frozen in place, so bear that in mind. And of course, we're leading around to the back of this warehouse now, I think. Now, we'll check this out later. Ah, okay, that's where I was before, and this was the corner we looked at before. So, it seems we've actually moved along underground into a new section of the map, which is nice. It seems that to get from there to here, you could also go outside, but also there's the underground route as well, so we'll bear that in mind. And of course, we've got a trader here, and we've got moving shadows, which means, while they may not actually be moving because the map is frozen, again, some parts of this will be frozen still, some of them won't be, so these leaves would be moving if they're not already. In fact, one of them is there, I can just about see. Meanwhile, we'll talk about the sky. It is nice to have a very, very beautiful sky moving past. Like, some of the clouds are very... actually moving in different directions. Okay, can I point out how weird that is? These clouds are moving that way. These upper ones are moving that way. Have a think about that. Because, you know, the wind is what moves the clouds, so... But yeah, also when it comes to detail for this corridor, one thing I do like is somebody has clearly noticed this light isn't working, so that's why you've got a ladder and some extra equipment that's just lying around here. Because they're here to fix stuff. So, now we're outside. I'm going to do some more like indoor sections. I'll probably go over there next if we actually focus too much on the outside stuff for now. And of course, we've got lots of long grass that's been put in here. One thing I do like is instead of someone just going, here's a grass texture, they actually put the long grass in it as well. Instead, we've kind of got a sort of a rocky dirt texture at the bottom, which makes sense. Instead of going grass and more grass, there's clearly some sort of weeds and growth here that is a bit longer than the sort of the regular stuff. And what I mean by that is people clearly walk around here, which means eventually the small grass has been worn away. And the areas that people don't walk on as much is why there's grass there. It's just extra stuff to think about when you're thinking, I'm going to do an outdoor grass section, what is it going to look like? So, basically we were in here originally, and there's more ways to go. So, if we go downstairs, you eventually get to the underground section, which we checked out earlier. And if I double back through this section, this is what we could see before. So we're going to try looking at this door, which I can see from over there, I believe. And of course, we've got a Zed spawn area, basically utilising the alleyways where players wouldn't be able to go, and of course we've got this damaged gate here, which the Zeds can jump over, but it's a very obvious way that players can't go, but it's a thought about where Zeds could come from. Now, let's have a check out of this area here. Again, I'm liking this extra detail on the floor. It's not necessary, but it's a way of making your floor look a lot more interesting than having the entire room look like this section here. I've got like a train carriage there as well, that's interesting. I think the doorway I could see from all the way down there was actually one that's probably over there, but let's start this section and work our way down. Also, what I was saying before about having the map being frozen, it means I can talk so much more about the map, which I do like when I'm doing a map review. I can like do a full review rather than just saying things as I go. Also, to mention about this car, it doesn't look like one of the standard models, and I'm actually kind of interested to know whether it is or not, because of course you can't see on the insides. I'm not sure if there's any purpose as to why it's a new car, like a new car model and texture. I'm guessing it's just there just to look interesting, as in rather than just copy and pasting too many things from the original source material. Now, can I actually get out here? Which is my crouch button? I can't, okay. It does look like, in fact, I should be able to actually go through this, can I point out. Now, obviously, this is at this height to make sure the Zeds can get through, but I think maybe adding in like a box here and there or something like that to make it a bit clear that players can't go through this. And of course there's a collectible over there, but look at this. I can't go through here and I'm not supposed to go through here, but look how much detail is in this. This is clearly very, very old flooring here. So much so that there's all sorts of weeds and plants and just dirt that's been collected over the top of all these concrete blocks, I think they are. And there's some even more machinery over here. I don't know what that's supposed to do, but that's blocked off so we can't really see. And there's even more warehouse buildings, I guess. Probably more of the same sort of stuff. So, look at all this. There's so much detail in this map. This is why I was so excited to see this in the workshop. Just look at the amount of detail that's been on this. Now, this guy hasn't done a map in a long time, and I'm guessing this has been what he's working on. And I'm not surprised it's taken this long. A lot of thought and time has gone into this. So, again, we've got some more frozen, flickering textures here that would be moving if this wasn't frozen up. And, of course, possibly another way for Zeds to get in here? I don't know. This warehouse is clearly damaged. And of course, this is an upper segment you can use to drop down, so we'll check that out in a second. We've got a trader here. This is a very obvious way to block out the sort of... What, did you see that? Yeah. Okay. These are sort of things to bear in mind when I'm doing a map review. I like to try and find these sorts of things that can be patched out later, but you can see that sort of thing here. Now, comparatively, this does look a bit bland compared to the rest of the room. In fact, only a few feet away. There's lots of detail on the floor here, yet this is kind of... I don't know, it's like unused, even if it was some sorts of things in here. Maybe some crates and things in the corner just to sort of make this sort of end bit look less bland. But even though we're talking about bland, if you look just above, there's more air conditioning, there's all sorts of grating and things like that. So there's lots of stuff that's been put in here. As far as extra detail on the top, this is clearly something that carries things along and puts them on the trains. I don't know where they picks them up from, I'm guessing it's further down there. We may get to see that, we may not. And of course, when you're thinking what sort of extra detail goes in here, well, how do you move this thing around? Well, it's got this kind of drop-down button press thing here. As for the train, that train's got a shit ton of detail on, and I'm actually kind of curious to see how much we'll get to see from this angle, because I don't know if we can actually go in there. That's actually not a floor, that's actually like the upper bar grating. Like, we can go around that corner, but we'll see what we can see from here for now, because I've not seen that model before. That looks original, and it's very well done. It's a very nice old steam train model. So again, we've got areas where Zeds can probably spawn from, but of course I can't get to. And of course, if you get stuck up here, you've got this little section you can use to drop down onto, I guess, safety grates. Thing is though, is I don't think I can actually heal myself. I can't remember if I can, so I'm not going to do any drop downs if I don't have to. Because if I do too many, I'll eventually die, and then that'll be me done. I mean, the embarrassment of dying on a frozen map is a bit much. So, the air conditioning's got to go somewhere. I'm guessing that's what this is. And of course, we still have some more wall detail out here. It's a very old brick design as well. Oh, some more dosh over there. Alright, so let's go have a bit more of a look at this train. See what we can see. There's probably some dosh on, like, attached to it somewhere, but this may be the most we can get out of it, I think, probably. So we've got one of these side rooms, there's extra storage here. Can I actually jump up these? No, okay, fair enough. Sometimes to stop players from jumping into very odd places, you can, as long as you make the like the table big enough, and like the crates big enough, you can have reason to just put like an invisible wall in there, just so you just can't get up there, just to sort of... Because, you know, when you make maps, sometimes players can get into really weird places that you don't want them to get into and can be kind of cheaty, so it's a good way to do it. And of course, we've got some interesting windows here that create a lot of detail on these walls, because bear in mind, these walls are actually fairly plain, and to add detail, this one's broken. Wow, good detail. Yeah, yeah. And of course, this one is, again, fairly plain, so by adding windows, and of course some here to produce shadows and light on this wall, it can add some extra detail in there when you're kind of running out of things to put there. Okay, this looks like a kind of lobby area. I'm telling just because it's got chairs and plants and stuff. And some more dosh. Can't collect it. Anyway. So, you've got some more lockers in here. I'm guessing this is where some of the workers get their stuff. Maybe someone has something a bit secret in there. And what is this? Again, it's one of those things, like, you can just put this sort of stuff in here. If it kind of looks like it makes sense, it doesn't really matter how it works. What is this? Security cameras. You know, I haven't actually seen any security cameras around here. I mean, we don't know where this is looking at, but it's looking at somewhere. I would find it very interesting if this was actually locations on the map that we haven't seen yet. It's very nice. And of course, we've got some more of this radio stuff, more electrical controls on the wall. Like a little board with some information. Let's see what's on here. I mean, feel free to try and like squint your eyes and try and see what some of that says, because I certainly can't read it. And of course, we can't open and close the doors either. So this brings us back to kind of this corner area. We've kind of sort of done a ring around, but not the center, so we'll get around to that in a minute. I also like the fact that you probably can't come back this way, but you can run up here and choose as a direction if you want to. And of course it makes sense that you've got these pallets and boards and metal plates to sort of get up the side of this bin here and jump over if you need. Tell you what, we'll finish off that building though. We've done some of it in this one. And of course, again, you can't get into this section it looks like, but you've got plenty of detail to show off as well. So that's some nice stuff there. It's a very odd way to do a newspaper, but okay, fair enough. Now there's lots of clutter out here. This is clearly a back alley where loads of the rubbish just gets dumped. There's some interesting stuff to see around here as well. And of course you can clearly see there's work done on it because you've got these coverings as well. Now where does this lead to? Ah, see, I mentioned it before. Like, these two guys are showing me exactly where this section was. And here it is. So again, there's another way to drop down here. I like the way that some of these trips are one way and some of these, if you go through the buildings, go both ways. It's an interesting way to make loops around your map. This roof's falling in. Right, let's see where this goes. I'm kind of curious now. Well, it leads to another building, so we'll see what's in here, shall we? Now, this is a very old building. It looks like it's had lots of bullet shots in the sides already, but this is somebody's bedroom, or at least was at some point. And of course, one thing I do like is when people add in doors that you can't get into that makes sense. Like, this is probably like maybe their side bedroom or something, but let's see what else we can find around here. Of course, we've still got some more lighting coming in here from various places. Yeah, that's clearly a side room that's very obviously blocked off. And there's some sort of club area maybe. Got some more dosh, we've got a pool table. Ah, this is eventually going to lead into the center room, so we'll get that to that. We will get to that eventually. And where does this go? Let's quickly check. Did I walk straight past this? I did. I actually missed this door. I completely missed it because I was looking at this, then I turned around to look at this. But yeah, okay, so we've got kind of the similar ideas here. We've got the wall in the background, we've got the metal bars and some damaged front section of the wall here as well. I also like how some of the walls are just broken. I don't know, maybe Zeds did that, maybe they didn't. All sorts of bricks on the floor as well. I do think it's odd that there is these little gaps, but then again, depending on how old this is probably just the side blocks that are thing there. And we've even got some more detail here. We've got like a little sink and electrical equipment next to a sink. Ooh, don't know about that. Remember kids, don't mix the two. And there's tons of side detail and upper detail in this little section as well. Like, each little section of this map just has tons and tons of detail on. I really like it. Don't forget, if you're making maps, make some notes of maps like this, because this is like some A-grade level map making here. You've got these little fancy little windows to look at here. I like the fact that when you need to show off a bit more detail on the map, you can actually have a good reason to add in windows and stuff. Because you could just have a wall here, but because there's actually windows here, you can probably see out to have a look at what Zeds are out there, or just show other sections of the map off. Because of course, these are blocked off, but bear in mind, that outer section of the map you can't travel to anyway, so there's not really much of a need to show it off. So these windows kind of make sense that they're covered up, probably boarded up from the outside as well. So walking onto this little bridge here, we can kind of see that you can actually go down here, but off to the side there you can't go, so it's interesting that there's sort of, I won't say mountains, but sort of like hilly areas with trees and stuff that are nicely covered up as well. Oh, got like a bit of castle work over there. See all the crenellations and stuff, but it seems off in the distance we've got lots of trees and stuff that kind of block out the stuff that the map maker doesn't want you to see, like the clear edge of the map, as it were. And of course you can, you can't jump over that, but you can jump off this section as well if you get stuck in. Ah, it's a hotel. Okay, I'm glad it was labelled because I couldn't exactly figure out what it was. And that's probably the main front area, which I think that little section was blocked off downstairs, but that's the way in anyway. Now, when it comes to open road sections, that's one of the good things to put in. Of course, you've got your lampposts, you've got your cars, and I'm guessing there's a mailboxes, or that says Gazette, doesn't it? So that's like a sort of place you'd buy a newspaper from. Alright, so, this is the center building that had Jesus on the side of it. Oh, interesting, that's like a bell up there. Now, of course, because I can't shoot the bell to find out if you can actually make bell noises off it, but this has clearly had some work done to it as well. all sorts of carpets and stuff in here. It's a nice change. It's a nice change to the workshop areas, which are all brick, where this is sort of a more bright, more plain-walled place. This is clearly a very different building, possibly some sort of church building. And of course, it's had its flooring removed. This is kind of like the stuff you would put underneath, like, the flooring. I mean, if there's enough of these boards, maybe it was entirely carpet or not, but it's one of those interesting things to think about. Like, if they've removed the flooring to replace it, what sort of stuff might they put over it? Well, more carpet, I guess. And can I jump over this? I can't jump over this, but it looks like I can go there. So we'll check that out soon as we get to that floor. And of course, I've got some sort of waiting areas here, and again, more windows to show off all the detail in the other sections of the map I'm not in right now. I like that. Something I definitely like about this. Oh, okay, we picked up the shovel we saw right at the beginning. And of course, this is a nice alleyway that leads to different sections of the map. It's a nice way to kind of like a midsection to move around, because of course you can move around in these buildings, you've got the route around there, and of course this little side alley, do a bit of quick travel. So yeah, obviously this has had some work done in it, so of course you've got all the scaffolding that was put there. And there's not really many tools that have been left around, but there's some more possible radio here. And this is the drop down I saw earlier. I was wondering where it was, so I was thinking it's nice that there's like a little cart they can drop down to. Again, this drops down to the underground section I was in the earlier part of the video. And this has got quite a lot of detail in it, just these little stairs here. Clearly it's kind of like an awkward place to have an entrance to a building, so some nice little stair detail here as well. I know, you may think, ah, so what? Well, I'm being very picky about everything. Let's think about a map review. As for where this goes, I'm guessing that's for the sewers, but of course we can't get in there. So just to double check, yeah. That was the two things you shouldn't mix, and I'm guessing these goes to like a completely blocked off section of the building. It doesn't matter if you don't want to make an entire building in your map. You can always just do parts of the building and block off the other sections. So we've got like a mark area here, and I like these sort of old-fashioned vehicles we see around this map. So I guess part of it's blocked off, there's lots of clutter around. But of course the food is still there. One thing I will say that I don't like is the fact that these are flat textures. Considering the detail that's been made to the other parts of the map, you come to here and it kind of looks a bit rushed in comparison. Considering how much detail was on those stairs in the corner, you come here and it's like, that's a flat texture. But yeah, that's probably one of the few things about this map I'm not too pleased to see. Considering like how my expectations have been raised by the entirety of the rest of the map. Got some interesting prices on there. And they're in pounds. Interesting. Makes sense. Prices may not make sense. Oh well, I guess I take that back then, huh? Now, here's a really good spot to just notice exactly how much detail the shadows and the lighting adds to the map. Like, cause this may be not a very nice market and stuff, but just having trees over here, like in the path of the lighting, just adds so much detail onto what would otherwise be a very bland white wall. So that's good. And of course, again, these kind of blocked off so players can't really get into any odd sections. It makes sense to do stuff like this, because otherwise you'd be able to like climb up on top of here. And some maps, some people actually want players to be able to access areas like that, but this one obviously not, and it still makes sense. Also, we've got some like damaged. We've got some damage there. It looks a bit odd, but I like how instead of just having like a section removed from the fabric, it actually looks a bit torn there. Possibly by claws or something, or maybe it's just old, who knows. And again, because this is a street area, you've got some postal stuff here. I believe that's a French postal symbol, even though this is in pounds, and the Gazette, I believe, is an English-only newspaper, but, you know, that's a bit of extra critique there. So, I'm guessing this is the other side of the outside area. So, let's go outside the section and have a look. So yeah, look at this extra outside detail. Clearly got like a castle with some French design on it, which is very interesting. And lots of grass, lots of rocks, and of course some sort of wooden fencing around here as well to help keep the players in track to make it clear which sections they can and can't go in. And just to have a quick okay. This may be the direction I didn't go in, but just looking up here, this is where I was not so long ago. Very detailed wall here. And of course, following the trees, following the grass, following the rocks, they eventually come down to this downstairs area. And with some sort of wooden cabin in. Also, I like the fact that this actually has detail in it as well. Like, they've left the door open, they've left a clear window here, so you can look inside. It looks like it's being cleared out, other than the dosh they've left behind. And there's some sort of blocks of hay there. But, again, we can't go into this little section there. But still, the fact that you can even see in here is actually quite interesting, because usually players would have... Usually map makers would have just sort of boarded that up. And of course, we've got some more dosh here as well. Someone needs to be collecting this stuff. So, the final area of the map to check out is this one direction I didn't go in, which may be the only one, and I believe it was, because I followed past this guy. Something I missed before is the fact there's actually some interesting water down here as well. It's actually kind of hard to see that there is water here, so it's no surprise I actually missed it. Where does the water end? I'm actually going by the noise you may not be able to hear because of the music, but... I start stepping into the water about here. I don't like how it's actually really hard to see if there is actually water here unless you stood here and looked. So at a distance you can kind of see it, but once you stand here, you just can't see it anymore, but that's that. So, just a reminder, if you do prefer this style of map review to the one where I'm actually making combat, oh god, that's actually kind of scary up close, isn't it? Then do let me know in the comments below. So thanks for watching, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.